I moved to New York City, was working in investment banking, you know, I worked at a mezzanine fund. So I'm working full-time, like, pretty long hours, and I used to always run. And then my sister, older sister, was like, you should try riding a bike. And I did a cyclocross race with her. So I loved it. Came back to New York, bought a bike. June 2008, I did a clinic in Central Park, introducing women to racing their bicycles, and I was hooked. And so started racing, started winning. Fast forward 1 year, July 2009, I quit my job, thinking I would just kind of have fun for a year, started winning some more. Next thing I knew, I had a contract with a pro team, which was at the time HTC High Road. So 2010, I turned professional, and now this is what I do for a living.
How you guys doing?
Yeah, good. Everything okay?
Good. Everything's cool.
Okay. I'll leave.
Thank you.
Hey guys.
Most other events that amateurs can ride, they ride either as individuals or they ride in a team. But the team is really just a collection of people wearing the same jersey. In the Trois Etapes, it's all about a number of riders within a team actually completing a stage. So what makes the Trois Etapes different from other events is that the riders and the teams need to use strategy to win the race, and that only happens in this event. Evie is probably one of the top three women pro cyclists in the world at the moment, and she showed that today in the prologue by absolutely creaming.
It's nice to be able to do what I love and know that I'm doing it that supports something that I care about. For Bicycle Relief, their logo is, you know, the power of the bicycle, and they bring the bicycle to a lot of communities in Africa, and you can just see how it transforms communities. And, you know, for me, it really transforms the lives of women and girls, which is where, you know, it's quite important. And personally, the bike has transformed my life, and so to be able to give something back is hugely important. Cycling sometimes can be intimidating, especially if you don't know it. So I think for girls and women, I would just encourage them, you know, not to be intimidated by, you know, the clothing, you know, having the right gear. Don't be intimidated by the clipless pedals. I started really slow. I remember I wouldn't actually ride from my apartment to the West Side Highway. I would walk it. So if you're nervous about the busy streets, walk your bike and then, you know, get on the road that you feel comfortable, or ask a friend to ride with you. Because once you start riding a bike, it's, you know, the freedom it gives you is incredible.